Welcome back to another episode of This Week on Channel 9. I'm your host, Christina Warren, Senior Cloud Advocate, and it is the end of June, and I just wanted to wish everyone a happy Pride. The Seattle Pride Parade is this weekend, and I'm going to be there to show my support of the LGBTQIA+ community. And also, just a quick note that next week we will not have an episode of this show because it's the 4th of July here in the United States, and that means that we get the day off of work to celebrate America. Yay! All right, enough about all of that. Let's get into this week's dev news. Okay, so first up, the new Windows Terminal is now available as a preview build in the Microsoft Store. I'm so excited. So the Windows Terminal was announced at Microsoft Build, and it's a brand new modern Windows app that lets all of your shells live together. So think the command line, PowerShell, PowerShell Core, Bash, all your various, you know, WSL flavors, etc. And even better, it's all open source and it's up on GitHub. And the app will be released in the Microsoft Store later this year, but a preview is available now. And because, like I said, it is a preview and there are still some niggles that need to be worked out. But if you're like me and you just can't wait and you didn't want to go through the build process, you can play with it now. And so I've got a link to the announcement post in down below, as well as the app in the Microsoft Store, and also a blog post from Scott Hanselman, everyone's favorite developer, that shows off some tips and tricks to customize the terminal to your liking. Check out some of the cool background stuff you can do. Next up, in some Xamarin news, the Xamarin team posted a blog post about migrating 32-bit Mac apps to 64-bit. And so when the next version of macOS comes out this fall, macOS will only support 64-bit apps. And so that means that all 32-bit apps will need to be updated in order to work. And although new Xamarin.Mac applications target 64-bit by default, any existing Xamarin.Mac applications that target 32-bit must be migrated to 64-bit to continue working in the future. And so I've got a link to that blog post that goes into more detail, and a link to some documentation on how you can migrate your app. In some Visual Studio Code news, both the Java and Python teams announced monthly updates to those languages. And so for Java, those updates include new code actions like the ability to generate delegate methods and constructors, as well as some performance improvements. And for Python, there is now a plot viewer with the Python window. Very cool. There's also parallel testing with PyTest and indention of run selection in the built-in terminal, which has been a really requested feature. And I've got a link to the blog post for both extensions in the show notes and description down below. And speaking of Python, that leads me to think about AI, and AI makes me think about TensorFlow, and you kind of see where I'm going with this, right? Right? Okay. Anyway, Microsoft Research just open sourced a great new AI debugging and visualization tool that they are calling TensorWatch. And TensorWatch is available on GitHub, and the Microsoft Research team describes it as a Swiss Army knife of debugging tools with many advanced capabilities researchers and engineers will find helpful in their work. And that sounds great. I wish I understood more about what it all does. But I've got a link to the GitHub repo documentation and the Microsoft Research blog post for more information. In some Visual Studio Code extension news, my colleague Aaron Powell just made my life easier with his new extension for managing profiles in VS Code. And so this is great for those times when you might want a different theme and font and editor setup for different purposes. So maybe you like one setup for screencasting, one for presenting, one for at home, one for at work. Aaron's extension is in the VS Code marketplace, and it's on GitHub, and it also works with the excellent Setting Sync plugin, or extension rather. And so I love all this, and thank you for making this, Aaron. On Channel 9 this week, we've got lots of great content. Over on the Xamarin Show, James shows off 4 awesome things in Xamarin.Forms 4.0. And over on 5 Things, John Papa learns 5 things about RxJS and reactive programming. And over on the Open Source Show, Ashley and Erica talk about using open data to build family trees. Links to all these shows are in the description down below. And now it's time for my pick of the week. Okay, so one of the best things, in my opinion, to come out in the last decade was the Raspberry Pi. And so this is a single board computer that has really made it easy for schools and makers and wannabe makers, like that's me, and researchers to do lots of stuff on very inexpensive and small hardware. And this week, the Raspberry Pi Foundation released the Raspberry Pi 4, and it is a beast. The new Pi is available with up to 4 gigabytes of RAM. It works with USB-C, it supports 4K output, and it has built-in gigabit Ethernet. And I cannot wait to get mine and start building some really cool IoT stuff. All right, let's be real. I'm probably just going to like use it for retro gaming. But regardless, this is awesome. And so I've got a link to the announcement post, as well as some links to some of my favorite Raspberry Pi projects. And let me know if you've used a Raspberry Pi and what you've used it for in the comments down below. Well, that does it for me. If you liked this video, please give it a like on YouTube. It really helps us out. And go ahead and subscribe to Microsoft Developer on YouTube for all of your dev news. See you next time.